1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Today I have two Reed pipe wrenches. Reed Manufacturing Company still makes a large line of pipe working equipment, pipe cutters, pipe threaders, and so forth, heavy duty tools today. But the company was started in 1896 in Erie, Pennsylvania, and in 1897, this was the first pipe wrench that they patented and produced. Patent date is August 10th, 1897, and it's a self-adjusting type wrench. I worked with this a little bit to try to figure out how it works. Let me go on to the second one. I don't have a date on it. I hadn't been able to find out any information on it. Don't know the model number on it, so I'm looking through trying to find it. But on this one, it works like all pipe wrenches do. It clamps on and then it rotates. Self-rotating, it rotates back so you can grab onto it. But and it works with different size pipes, as you can see. It's that extended upper lip that gives you the ability to clamp onto a pipe automatically. When I get to this wrench, there's really no way to get a grip except by pulling back on this and getting it onto the piece of pipe, and you can eventually get it on there, but it's difficult. It also can pinch the hell out of your hand, and you can see how it's adjusted to where it'll ratchet down and grip the pipe. It also seems to be a strange mechanism here. This is spring-loaded. And I don't know why this inner jaw, you know, you've got your top jaw and your bottom jaw here that grip. I don't know why this is loose. It looks like it might have been pinned, but there's no holes down in the that I can find unless it's sheared off. But I don't know why this floats and or is solid. Either one, it wouldn't make it work any differently. It's the top jaw here that rotates around and grabs, and of course with this piece being loose, it catches on there. You can see the spring that gets the tension on it to snap it back into place. So if this was an automatic wrench, it didn't work that well. And I look back at pictures of the original wrench, and it looks like this wrench. It doesn't look like there was any additional components on here. Maybe for a first try, it just wasn't really a very good wrench. But now I did see a picture of one on the internet, and it was from Australia on for sale for $75. It didn't give an explanation on it. And this top jaw was extended out quite a ways, which would have made sense. Then you could grab onto something. But the problem is this jaw won't extend. It's pinned on here. Pinned right there. That's where it pivots. That's not going to go anywhere. So I don't know how this would extend out. I really don't understand how it works. If anybody happens to know anything about this wrench, it's called a, I don't even know if we have a name on it. I just know the date. It looks like model 16 on here. It's pretty rough to read, hard to read. And it's got the date of manufacturing. It does say Reed Manufacturing Company, Erie, Pennsylvania on it. And the patent date. And I did find the information on it, but can't figure out how it works. But it's really old, made in 1896. This was made at a later date and works a heck of a lot better. It looks like a piece of equipment that would be easier to use and But we'll go ahead and get them cleaned up, see if we can dig up some more information on them. So the work is done on the reed pipe wrenches. If you remember what they looked like before. First, the old one from 1897. The company was started in 1896, so this is one of their first items they produced. And here it is with the restoration on it. We took the old discolored metal and cleaned it and wire brushed it as best that we could over and over again. Tried to get all the crud out. It's got a lot of imperfections in it, which we're not going to take out. There's some heavy pitting in here. And taking all that out would be involved. I did find out a few things by working on this wrench. One is, I talked about how hard it was to work and get a clamp on anything. And I saw other wrenches demonstrated. And then I realized that they made them in different sizes. This is the smaller one. And then, of course, the other ones had a jaw that was extended out quite a ways. Made it look a little different, but it was also easier, and it was for bigger pipes. This is not a real large one. This piece, this little collar on here, was actually branded or pinned down. It wasn't movable. The only reason I can see why it was even a separate piece, I think they were just made separately and then assembled onto here. So instead of machining one solid piece, so this jaw became, I guess you could say, replaceable with a lot of work, because it's a, but it was loose, but it still works because you get a grip with both jaws when you have it open. And the teeth are in good shape. Again, their first try at a wrench, I don't think it was a great wrench. The only painting I did on it was just a little. I used a black for an accent rather than a red, since we put red on so many items. Next is a wrench that I could not find any history on that they made later. And it just has a name on it, Reed Manufacturing Company, Erie, Pennsylvania, USA. And a nice wrench. I made it a little nicer with the restoration. Did a little bit more on it, took this upper area here and polished it because it would look like it was done that way originally. The base metal on here was just sort of a stippled finish all the way around. And then this upper jaw portion, and then here, the lower jaw, were looked like they had been shined, so I took it back to what I thought was the original look on this tool. Couldn't find any real information to support anything on this wrench. Couldn't find this wrench in their history. This one actually works very well. It's one of those that you can take and slam onto the work, and it gets a grip, and it, you know, ratchets so you can turn. And the tighter you pull on it, the tighter the jaws will grip. So a lot easier wrench to use, not a really large one. It may have been made in different sizes, but I couldn't find a catalog or literature or anything on this, and there's no patent number, so there's no way to do any research. But gave it a nice look, like we like to do. It'll be great on the display for these type of wrenches. I'm getting quite a few of them now, so if I ever get moved, which I don't know, the virus here has got me delayed. I haven't done anything about getting moved, but as soon as things move along, I'm going to move to an area where I have, number one, a big shop, a double garage instead of this little single I got, and an old-fashioned single, so it's not real large. And then I'm going to do some displays a little differently by grouping tools by category. I've got so many tools right now. I got my wall full and I got my drawers full of tools I don't even have out. So I think a good way to show the tools would be to actually build a display, separate little display area for each style of tools. So this would be one category here. So the reeds were a new addition. I didn't have any reed pipe wrenches before. They turned out nice. This one turned out really pretty. But in its own right, this is an unusual wrench. Made in 1997, their first try. Thanks for watching my video.